10 a.m., 21st of November, 1916.
Approximately 12 mines. Now, mines are indiscriminate killers. When Britannic hit one of the contact fuses on the mine detonated. Resulting explosion. And gas bubble, lifting Britannic's bow with it. It twisted Britannic's hull a bit, slightly warped her frame, which resulted in the watertight doors in boiler room 6 and 5
deal comfortable, and I went to the locker and got out the captain's megaphone according to orders, and I stood alongside the captain on the bridge to see if he had any orders for me. The ship seemed to be leaning a bit to the starboard side, and she still seemed to be going ahead a little. Second Fremantle Scout Troop Patrol Leader, James Vickers.
I permitted myself to return to their cabins, so long as it was done with haste. We're all too familiar with the dangers of ship sinking. The Lusitania was only a year ago, and the Titanic only 3 years ago. Nurse matron of the HMHS Britannic, Miss Elizabeth Ann Dowes.
As we were walking out of the saloon, the signal went and blast rang out from the siren. Not until then would I believe that there was any danger. I distinctly remember as we quietly walked down the beautiful marble staircase. Streamed in the portholes, lighting up all our lovely cabins. This was goodbye to everything. Our ship was sinking. How fast? We didn't know. Nurse A. de Garland, Voluntary Aid Detachment.
After we got clear of the danger of the ship, we started to rescue our comrades that was in the water. We had no one to man our boats, so we carried on ourselves.
I'll look at some of them.
jumped. Quarterdeck, and after swimming clear, we watched the awesome sight of the mighty liner sinking.